You got to play a real clean game. Yeah. Trades are bad. Like scrambles where everyone's getting hit is bad. And
it only takes one up smash.
It only takes
know?
One, you know.
And that's gonna happen a lot. Just like some chip shot from like Yoshi's super fast and arrow, just puts you in that position where like up smash is just there. And obviously, you know, Rickles is getting a lot of side B conversions.
And we're going to get rolling right away.
So this is Grand Finals, guys. I know it says Loser Finals, but it's Grands. And then
and we got
Grands.
We got two Clouds.
That was Loser's Finals right there. Because that was best of five.
It is a small but incredibly stacked bracket today. Which so maybe causing some confusion.
Well, that's what they just played that. No, that was the one on stream like a second ago.
And as this game is going on, we're trying to figure out a little bit of
we're
who's
good.
Just, who's doing what?
So we have Rickles and McMuffin versus Z2G and Marshall. Oh my gosh!
Wow, that fully charged F smash will kill you at real low.
Yeah, he just got. I mean, there was nothing really he could do. He got stuck in that no man's land where he's in hit stun still. And I mean, Gandalf was pretty smart, just like charging that smash in the opposite direction. That was, I mean, maybe. Kind of lucky, but you know, still good. Nice.
Oh,
see, that was good back
gets
air.
It.
Tripped.
On the banana.
Oh.
Nice. Good recognition with that.
All part of Marshall's 15-step plan.
I mean, he probably covered every possible option. I mean, if he would have rolled away or got up, attack, that was beautiful spacing.
Oh, yeah, he had nowhere to go. That's as good as you can get. So we have, two. So we have, see, it's weird though, because McMuffin is now playing Ganondorf, and Rickles is now playing Cloud.
You're right.
So
I didn't notice that.
They switched it a little bit now. We'll see how that works, but no jump. Oh, he had a jump. Never mind. Lied.
Maybe he feels the best counter for a Cloud is another Cloud.
I mean, it's
not a bad idea. I've thought about it myself.
Yeah, I mean, like, that's not a bad idea, but I'm surprised he didn't go Yoshi because that was just doing so well. You know, maybe he's got, you know, maybe Cloud versus Yoshi is not the best.
Me and Kimaru have talked about how terrible that matchup is. It's rough for Yoshi. And nice Yoshi
grab.
Usually has great matchups.
That was kind of was a good grab from ZTG into holy crap.
Wow. Explosions. Ooh, nice Nair. Nair is such a good edgeguarding tool, especially for a character that has really crappy recovery.
Yeah. Linear as hell.
Linear.
That was, okay, there's just jank going on. People are getting grabbed out of stuff. People are getting hit out of weird.
No one knows what's going on.
See,
nice.
That was good tech.
Good DI in. Then he techs it. Just having trouble following everything that's going on. Things are happening real fast.
Oh, see, the back air kills him pretty far away.
That was a very fortunate circumstance in Ganondorf tripping on that banana.
See, good air dodge from Gandorf, though. That was smart. He knew that Marshall had pretty much his number on that one. Oh,
nice.
That was just...
Well done.
He threw something, got some lag from it. I'm not sure what he did, but...
Can't quite convert on that one, but the yellow team, nice.
That's tough, because he buffers something, then he gets beat up on the stage, and... I mean, but the worst thing could have happened was that, you know, Ledge Trump back air is pretty damn good.
Yeah. Ledge Trump back air is pretty good.
Okay. Marshall's trying to catch him getting on that platform, which is smart.
That beefy down smash.
Dude, that's the worst.
It's real hard. Oh, and this game turned around real fast.
I mean, they're throwing heat, man. They're throwing
they
heat.
Are. See, the thing that Diddy Kong has that, that Pikachu did not have is fast throws. He can throw them and get the hell out of there.
And if he can get a banana out, which he's probably not going to try for at least a moment, but see, that's good. See, what he did right there was down tilt into back air like that. Keeps himself safe and then just kind of gets through him.
Marshall is really utilizing Diddy's frame data very intelligently. Oh, we got some team combos, though.
And that's what we kind of get. I mean, of course, Rickles and Igmo know how to play this game. They are in Grand Finals.
They are in Grand Finals.
See, that's the scary thing.
It's like, when do you jump, when do you not jump, and that's going to be a stock.
Yeah,
now it's a 1v1. Crazy good job from Marshall. Let's see if he can finish it off.
That
was... Oh!
Game blouses.
Marshall.
Hail high,
okay,
judges.
just in case... just to make sure everyone was paying attention just now. It was a trip on the banana peel to edge-canceled side B footstool.
Yeah.
He edge-canceled that side B into a footstool. Is that not what he did?
Yeah, and then he downed, I mean, or something
like that. He down-smashed, recognized the crap out of it.
Yeah, he knew he still had a jump right after the footstool, so he down-smashed, covered the edge, caught his head or something like that, and then, you know, just game over for Cloud.
To be honest, it's really hard to counterpick and counterplay against just good
Smash
Brothers.
So stolen.
Give me that. Game one, please.
Good job, Marshall, obviously.
Really, really, really clutch.
I mean, yeah, they had a really... He 2v'd one for probably the 2 minutes or so. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, just good play. There's not a lot you can say about that.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, just close. Close game. I think ZHG is probably going to step it up a little bit more in this game because he did really well, and there's no doubt, but they just missed a little couple conversions, you know.
I mean, the real question is who can outcloud the other cloud.
Yeah, ZHG is as intellectual a player as he can come. You know, he studies the game.
Yeah,
so.
We obviously mac Marshall a lot, but ZHG is a phenomenal player. He's number two on the PR for a reason.
Yeah, see, Marshall's got the tricks and, like, gimmicks and all that stuff and, like, how to play really fast.
And as we saw, very, very clutch.
Super clutch.
Super clutch plays. And the Ganondorf McMuffin getting beat up a little bit.
See, ZGG's definitely been in his... Oh, this is scary.
Oh! Very smart.
Some weird hitbox. I'm not sure if he could attack that. I don't even know what he should have done. That was the craziest thing.
That was crazy. I don't know what's going on.
Well, he downs beat spiked him right there. He hit both of them. Oh.
What the... I'm done.
It was just unfortunate. I mean, I'm sure Marshall was not ready to... DI in or anything along those lines. He's probably throwing something.
You know, in retrospect, trumping a Ganondorf is probably the safest option because a lot of the times you're either going to get hit if you're too high or you're going to get command grabbed.
Yeah, and if you throw in a hitbox, his grab doesn't really come out, actually. So, like, you can trade kind of jankily with him. He gets sent, like, semi-downwards.
Plus, a Ganondorf without his jump just needs one more hit on him.
God, see, that's the thing. Marshall knows how to, like, Marshall knows how to bait out these attacks and just, like, perfect shield them, you know, and then obviously if you have a banana hand with your shield, just like instant combo. That was good. See, that's the thing.
And ZTG loses his stock. Rickles loses his as well. And just, the yellow team is looking real strong right now.
That was good. See, yeah, good DIN though.
Nice up air to cover that ledge, but he clips his up B at the very end of it.
Marshall's reading a roll on, but he jumped, which is fine, which is good, you know, good option. But, you know, Marshall's thinking.
I like the decision to only throw the single jab out there.
See, that's just the combination of Marshall's reaction time sometimes just really gets him. So that was.
Yep, that was Rickles understanding that Marshall's rolling to safety, and he just might as well throw that down smash.
1%, all part of the plan.
Yep, he'll need that 1% later.
Oh, see, that's it. The patience. Used his.
Ooh, oh. Smart to wall ride. Really cautious of that nair from Cloud. Edge cancel not quite working out exactly how we needed it to that time, but.
Ooh, nice get up attack. He's pretty scary.
Oh, and he goes for the banana catch, but gets hit by that big old Buster Sword.
Ooh, oh, Marshall was going for it. That was a good trade, though. He almost had that.
Yeah, if he had a couple frames earlier, that would have been a down air.
Marshall knows how to get away from stuff.
All right, and this is looking real like just a job to clean up this last Ganondorf stock from the yellow team.
I think ZCHI's got it. Isn't really good. Marshall, good time pushing away from the edge. Oh, see, that's the worst. He went for an F-tilt, and Marshall went for a grab and just got that low.
Yeah, doing something you think is fast and then trading with a beefy hit from Ganondorf is just like, ugh. Oh, just drops the peel on him.
Yeah, dude, Z drops it, gives him the...
Come on, just get this banana peel out of my face. Didn't even hit me hard. Ugh. Much, much stronger appearance that game from the yellow team. Let's see how the... I don't know what color they were, the blue team?
I mean,
see how they adjust.
ZGG is really good with platforms, too. You know, he's pretty good at tomahawking and just getting grabs because people just assume you're going to throw hitboxes. I mean, he plays other characters, not just top tier, so... Like, he's definitely got the tricks for... Developed the tricks from the other characters and stuff.
Yeah, little known fact, actually, you know... Best Mii Gunner in the state.
Oh, yeah.
Beast,
yeah.
Actually, and that I don't say that in, you know, I don't say that as a joke. He's like, he will destroy you with his Mii Gunner. Interesting.
Yes, I guess McMuffin and they just feel like this is the best way to do it. I mean,
this is a big body team.
See, now Rickles is... Ganondorf and, I mean, I think Ake McMuffin.
They're really trying to make it tough
Ake
for
McMuffin,
us, you know?
McMuffin, yeah. He's got obviously a plethora of characters that he's trying to use.
Maybe they just felt that any mix up doing anything differently.
Well, see, I would say, like, maybe the Donkey Kong Cloud matchup is not very good. Like, maybe you just assume. And then, but,
Yeah.
But Falco Donkey Kong is probably not too bad. It's probably in, I mean, it's probably in Donkey Kong's favor, to be honest.
Interesting. Marshall just grabbed him right out of that.
Oh, see, that was a horrible. That was a good trade, but it was. I mean, I don't think. I don't think he wanted the non-spike hitbox. That was good. Yeah. See, McMuffin's got some tricks. You know, he's trying to do like the grab release off the edge into double jump spike. You know, stuff like that. But
it's kind of funny watching Donkey Kong throw that banana. Just looks weird to me.
Yeah. See.
Wrong monkey.
See, this is the scary thing. Ooh.
And he didn't have his invincibility, so it was pretty understandable that he tries to recover over the ledge and use a hitbox. Let's see if they'll pick up on that next time.
Smart for Eggman Muffin. Doesn't even try to trade with his down. A lot of people get into a habit of like multi-hit jabs like that. Holy freaking
wow,
DI.
that angle.
Yeah.
That angle. Now we have a weird situation where it's four stocks to four.
He's going to spike him. Oh, he
Misses it by a tiny bit.
Yeah, I mean, I think McMuffin definitely, like...
He's trying to two-frame him with that down air.
Yeah, he was definitely... Well, he had no invincibility because he let go, but I think he was, like, trying to come back a little bit.
I think he's just trying to two-frame him because he's a boss.
Boss! Yo, so this is the problem, heavy hitting.
Yeah, I mean, you think you're ahead, and then a couple things happen. That was nice, recognizing that the banana is going to come down there. Let's just back air you into it.
Dude.
Wow.
I mean... That was just unfortunate, but, you know, the biggest hit of Ganondorf's. Oh, that was crazy.
Yeah, just a little bit of 1v1 going on. Not a ton of team combos.
D2G's got the, trying to get the vine combos, you know, the down throw into, like, random stuff. Nice. Nice spacing for Marshall. That was
and
good.
That low ending lag up smash coming in handy. Gets the beefy jab. It's a weird thing to say, but oh, man. He's going to have to take a stock here unless Marshall...
I mean, Marshall's a badass, so...
Marshall can... He's known to clutch things out.
Tech?
No.
That's hard.
It is. You can actually tech command grabs even if they're extremely close, but the timing is just so much weirder when it's that little...
Yeah.
That little space.
Shout out to Reflex Wonder for, like, finding out half the stuff, but...
Yeah. Reflex Wonder. Quick 30-second videos that tell you everything you need to know.
Nice.
Wow.
Oh.
Wow. Is he going to do it again?
One as deep as possible. That's it. This is scary.
And Marshall understands what he needs to do in this situation. Gimp them completely. And I also, don't miss any techs because, you know, ooh, that backer from Donkey Kong has always been a staple move of his, and it's always been real strong.
Yeah. And you can just kind of throw it out, because if he would have whiffed, he still had back air unlocked for the second one.
Yeah, I feel like that game never really was in anyone's advantage too much. It just kind of slipped out of Team Wisconsin's fingers.
Yeah, I'm not sure what they should really... I mean, they didn't do anything.
It was pretty tough to tell what was... I feel like there was really no single contributing factor to that game.
Unfortunately, Falco's got very little landing options, really. Like, you can fair, and you can down air, I guess, and like nair and stuff, but unless you're like actually back airing, like spacing it, like Ganondorf is just gonna up.
And heavies have a tendency to try to stay on the ground. It's where they're safe and get through their big, fat, beefy moves. It's like gets the roll in, up smashes it.
And with the shield stun and stuff, like Ganondorf is still like a viable, like, you have to respect him still. Oh, see, that's.
I respect the attempt. Is he gonna do anything with the lack of invincibility?
That was pretty close. Marshall was pretty close on getting like. He likes doing that, though. It's you run off and then like double jump backwards into a fair, so you have that hitbox in front of you. It's like a pretty common tactic.
It's smart, and it's really hard to get around. That forward air is such a brick of a hitbox.
And like even if you miss, like you're trading with up B and you know it's tech it, or like he might lose out because it's an attack.
So. Oh, instant throws the banana just to be like, I'm techie, I know stuff.
Okay, this is the scary thing. Oh my.
Oh, and they both fall to their death.
All part of Marshall's plan.
Yeah, it decides not to tech it. I don't know. Okay. ZGG understanding they're at low percentage runs right back in with that nair. And that limit neutral B can put on a lot of damage, and it's also very safe.
Marshall can just go in because, you know, he's obviously very skilled. And, like, ZGG can just, oh my gosh.
Yeah, ZGG can just play with his brain, and he's great. He's great at it.
Yeah, he can definitely.
He's got a very smart brain.
Yeah.
There's a lot of smash stuff.
That was unfortunate. He teched away, which is you know, whatever. And then, like, of course, like, charge up smash in the opposite direction. Like, it's like, oh, I'm good. Oh, the worst.
The worst. And expects a roll, doesn't get it.
So.
Says, get this banana out of my face. What are you doing, Marshall? Ooh, yeah. Smart. Fades back with the forward air.
Yeah, fades back.
Beautifully
forward
spaced by McMuffin. McMuffin likes forward airs that spike, I guess.
I mean, that was good spacing, too. He didn't just go out and do it. He kind of just waited and drifted back.
Mm. There's been a little bit of friendly fire coming from the yellow team. And see
nice
if they can clean
throw
that up. This would be a lot,
a wacky
a lot
DI,
more one-sided.
Probably wasn't ready. I think that if he would have GI'd that a little better, he probably would have recovered. But
maybe a missed input, maybe a slight mistake.
It and happens, then of course,
happens to everybody.
Ooh, that's scary.
See, what Marshall does is make sure he covers the jump right away option.
See, Marshall's getting pretty damn close to spiking him. He just, I mean, for the luck of the draw with Gandorf, he's got that little like attack kickbox on his up B, so.
And by the way, if none of you folks at home have noticed, Rickles is really good. Okay, the top part of Ganondorf's up B is actually a hitbox. It's not a command grab, and he spaces it in such a way that the hitbox hits above the ledge as he's recovering to it. So it makes it a little bit safer.
Some jank going
some
on?
Some very, very good subtlety from Rickles.
Oh
my goodness.
Oh, my God. He just does it. Ugh. He's a big fan of that. Like, you
throws
know,
that forward air.
You jump early just because you want to go deep, you know, against Ganondorf and stuff and up B's. Oh.
Can Marshall do it again? Knows he's going to edge cancel because he's, you know, good and stuff.
Living still, good DI from Marshall. Yeah. It's just scary. He's got good recovery. Any little chip thing will kill him.
Yep. Any move. And it's going to game five.
I mean, that was pretty close. Unfortunately, I mean, fortunately, I guess for McMuffin, he was getting those spikes pretty handedly, I guess.
Yeah, you know, we're talking about one team being having clutch plays, but that was a clutch play.
Yeah,
clutch play if I've ever seen one.
He's just doing it too. Like he's not waiting for it. He's just knowing that like, oh, it's like if I back throw him, they're gonna have to react.
As a heavy, you're often gonna have a lot of frame disadvantage, so when you understand a player is gonna be aggressive and DI towards you, a fade back and throwing a big heavy hitbox is never a bad option.
Rickles has started off every game like that. Standing in front, just down B's, deal with it. smart dog tech.
Ooh. Ooh, that was catches DK on the chin with that one.
See, that was
ooh,
good.
Oh, wow. You don't see a lot of Ganondorf gimps.
Unfortunately, he got hit towards the stage. It's probably the DI that Xander had, but like that was pretty good. Was
all right, banana in hand, and stage control on deck.
This is scary. See, I like ZGG because he utilizes that was kind of lame. ZGG really utilizes back air a lot. He really likes that.
I mean, I would say maybe with up, other than up air, back air is probably Cloud's strongest aerial.
Yeah.
And there's really good too. And he's got a lot of good ones. Never mind. Stupid Cloud.
Yeah, he just like knows how to like really like space those back airs. So like if someone hits him on shield, it's just like so much space.
And unshielded at the wrong time. Yeah. He had limited everything too.
Rickles is
the closest.
Rickles is definitely going for the edge.
Ooh, nice.
So I'm saying that
gets him with it too. And
spikes mean something at Smash 4. We're like, what's well, not spikes or meat or whatever, smashes.
I mean, whatever. It's the moves that make people go down.
But you just can't cancel it, and it's just like, oh, if you get spiked, it's death.
You got to sit through all that hit lag.
Like, yeah.
And he's going to throw his. I like the confidence in his teammate. Z2G is good enough to be able to convert on that. Pretty much every time.
That's the jank. See, well, Marshall right there was doing a great job, and then the problem was the limit, whatever it was. It, like, zoomed in on him so he couldn't see himself. He was just like, where am I? You know? It's like, yeah, that's the problem.
He was trying to buffer another down tilt and gets pushed off.
So he got pushed off, but he still wall jumped fair to keep himself safe.
It's just fast reaction times and understanding what your character's capable of. And beautiful angle on that.
Yeah.
See, Diddy Kong's a lot like Fox in Melee with this game, at least with the angles of his recovery, and steals that one. Wow. Dominant performance from the yellow team, and it's going to be
death.
I was going to say,
well, that was Grand Finals, guys. I mean, the last game probably wasn't a good representation of how the whole set went, but
Yeah, Rickles and McMuffin played...
No slouches.
Or, oh, no, absolutely not.
They definitely threw a kind of a loop for him with, like, different characters and stuff, but, I mean, Marshall and ZTG definitely pulled it off.